Hello, everyone. How are you? I hope this finds you well and excited as we are for the TGBE Midwinter Market. Thank you for your comments. I see you here, and I just want to start out by thanking you all for tuning in with each of your presenters, and we're very happy you're here. And if for those of you who do not know me, I'm Jill McKay, and I'm coming to you from a very cold Colorado. I live in northern Colorado, and I thought it was so cute when Kate said it was cold in California. I love Kate. She always does such a great job. And this morning I woke up and it was 17 below, and that is not wind chill. I went out to start my car to come down to my studio here in Fort Collins, and it kind of went and I thought, oh my god, just for a second I didn't think it was going to start, but it did, and I'm here and we are having a good time. So I want to go over a couple of housekeeping things. I want to tell you about, number one, we got the coupon code for 20% off everything in my store at jillmckay.com except the Tucson bead boxes. And I will tell you a little bit about those in a little bit. But please, you know, write that down. It's just all capital letters, TGBE20. So you can use that coupon code started yesterday, today, tomorrow, and it ends on midnight on Sunday. So, let's come back up here. I also want to invite you to my private group, a Facebook group called Jill McKay's Creative Tribe. And all you have to do to join is answer one question. And that question is, will you follow the rules? And I will let you in. So, we're over 1,000 members strong, and people get to share the images of what they make, and we talk back and forth. A lot of times I give coupons only to the tribe members, and then I also let tribe members know ahead of time before I turn to let everyone in the public know. So there are some benefits besides. It's just a wonderful group of people. So I hope you'll consider joining. I also want to say that I do my lives on Facebook and YouTube at jillmckay.pro. That's my page. So I do them on Wednesdays at 2 p.m. Mountain Time and Sundays at 1 p.m. Mountain Time. I try to be as faithful as possible. But most of you know I just took a week off and was in Hawaii, and wow, it really helped me a lot. My whole life is about creativity, and to me, it's not just making a living. Creativity to me is the way I make a life, and truly my favorite place to be. So when I'm creating, I'm in a very focused and quiet, my mind is quiet, and I'm just in the moment, and I just love it. So getting to share all of this with you is very important to me. Today we're going to be working on the Hearts Renewal Necklace Kit, and this has a special theme, and for me, Heart Renewal, that's what I just did while I was in Hawaii, because I was pretty worn down and my mind was tired. And it's really important to stop and take a look within. But this project, I want to share some information with you about Hearts Renewal. So it's a very simple project. So while I'm streaming, so I pre-recorded some things that I wrote down and then recorded with my voice. So as I'm stringing along after we get the pendant part made, I will be sharing some of those things. And I want you to let me know if you find this If you like it, if you find it annoying, if you don't like it, I need to know because I want you to like my presentations. I want you to be happy with them. You all liked the last, the Fall Fest kit in which we did some very personal work. Today, I just want to talk mostly about heart wisdom, not heart new. It's not heart renewal. It's heart wisdom kit. Oh my goodness. Anyways, I renewed my heart in Hawaii, but this is the heart wisdom kit. And the heart has a whole nother intelligence, but heart wisdom isn't just, it's not just your heart. So we'll talk about, I'll share those things while we're working along, okay? So now most of you know that I usually use really nice gemstones in my kit. And this time you can see that these are wooden beads. And then, of course, we have some American turquoise. But the pendant here, both the beads and this beautiful wooden pendant are dark walnut. And they've been hand-carved by an artisan couple from the United States. So when you are purchasing my kits, you are also helping other artists. I love to do that. I love to spread the goodness around. And there's a lot of artists that aren't as lucky as me. I'm what Kate calls the OG. So I actually helped start jewelry making as a trend in this country. And I've been very blessed in my career. So I'm very happy to share the goodness. So you're also supporting other artists when you support me. I want to thank you in advance for any orders that you may place and tell you how much your support means to me, because it definitely does, as Candy would say, keeps the lights on. I don't do anything else. So thank you all so much. All right. I know what I was going to say. I wanted to tell you a little bit about these wooden beads, about trees in general. I won't take too long, but I kind of want to give you a paradigm shift of wood, basically. Everybody think, you know, compared to gemstones, it's an inexpensive. But these weren't, because they're hand-carved in America by artists. But what is amazing about trees, and this is information that they've just found out in the last 5 years, is that trees, they now know that trees can communicate. They use their root systems, and there's some words I can't even say, but let's just say it's a natural internet. They have also found out they have a voltage-based system that is an alarm. Let's say that somebody walks up and starts chewing its leaves, that sends that alarm down through the trunk, out through the roots. It warns other trees that this is happening. And together they all start producing tannins, which means they're making the leaves taste less because their leaves are actually part of the way they're breathing. They have found out that, it's really just kind of amazing what they're finding out about trees. So once upon a time, this was a beautiful dark walnut tree. So I just wanted you to be able to appreciate just a little bit more. So I see somebody said that they couldn't get the audio. I want you to go ahead and refresh your page and see if that works. And if that doesn't work, then plug in some earphones. That usually works. So, all right. Well, thank you for all your compliments. Let's go over what's going to come in the kit. If you have bought one, there's a few left in the store, and you can get 20% off right now. So, obviously, we have the beautiful hand-carved. They're so well made. They're so, so beautiful. I'm just going to go to my hands now. And it comes with this little insert. And once we finish our bead embroidery on this guy here, then we're going to insert it. But there's also, you're going to get 15 O teals and then a group of little beads that go within Oh, good. I'm glad you can hear me. Anyways, there's a lot of weather going on in the country, so it could be disruptive. So you're going to get a really nice magnetic clasp. You're going to get your beading wire, your crimp tubes. You're going to get your 8 millimeter, and you're going to your 8 millimeter walnut beads, and then these are 12 millimeter walnut beads, or 10 millimeter, anyways. So you're going to get a whole strand, a whole 15 inch strand of the 6 millimeter American turquoise, and I've split this up into two groups of 30 beads each. That's how much we're going to use on each side of the strands. You'll need a paintbrush, which you provide, a 10 long needle or a 10 sharp, a pair of scissors, and your favorite beading thread. I'm using, what am I using? Oh, names escape me. It's one of the leading brands. Anyways, I kind of want to tell you how I went through designing. So this is my image and it's printed on canvas. So I just want to show you how the story of your pendant. This is a terrible photo, but this is wait a minute. All of a sudden, when I'm looking at Facebook, it doesn't show. It's not showing. There we go. It's catching up. All right. So this was my original sketch. Sorry about that. I'm sorry. There's a shadow over it. But I sit and draw and draw and draw and draw. And this was an idea I had for a bead, actually, or a bead that can act as a pendant with a hole down through the middle. So then I copied that by hand drawing it onto some watercolor paper. 1G, thank you. That is what I use. And I sketched it onto watercolor paper, and then I used watercolors to kind of paint it in, and it wasn't very crisp or clean. I wanted it to be, to look hand painted, but then I scanned it into a digital program and started cleaning it up. And that was me a quarter of the way through. And then I got to this point and he looked angry and it looked hard to me. So I did a couple different iterations, but this was the one I finally ended up with. Okay. And I really love this symbol, and I hope that you like it too. So, when I designed this, knowing it would be printed on canvas, I had these little tabs here. So, when you were finished beading and bead embroidering it, we could fold those tabs, cut it out, and fold those tabs and glue it on. Well, I didn't know that to print on canvas, they paint the surface, making it a little too thick to use these tabs. So once we have done our bead embroidery, we're literally going to cut those off. Okay, so let's get started. Get some things out of the way here. I think I went over everything. We're going to start our bead embroidery, and what we're going to do first. Let me get the necklace back out. I got a needle in my mouth. We're going to embroider all the way around the outside edge. Okay, so what I want to share with you is when you are coming up and going down through the canvas, you want to stay inside the color of this circle. Okay, if you go outside this line, you may trim into your stitches when we cut it off. So please be very careful. You can't see from the back, but I'm going to eyeball it, and there, I am well within that circle. So I'm coming up. I'm going to leave about 4 inches of tail, and I'm going to move my little 15 O teal seed beads that we're going to be using. I'm going to pick up three of those. We're going to pick up three at a time each time as we go along. Okay, so we have three. Maybe I'll zoom in a little bit here. There we go. Three. And then I am going to, I'm laying this down on the surface. I'm taking my thread and I'm pulling it following the shape of the circle. Basically, what you want to do is to get your beads in the, so they're not spread out, and then place your needle right at the end of those three beads. And I'm going straight down with my needle. I'm not shifting my needle one way or another. Okay, so there we have our three beads. Now I'm going to turn it over and I see this hole that I made before, and I'm just going to go right back in that hole and pull my thread through. Leave part of my tail. Oh, that's not my tail. This is my tail. I'm pulling the wrong one. Okay, then I'm going to go right back through those three beads just like that. Okay, whoop, I moved and lost my three beads. So there we go, just like that. Okay, I'm going to put my thumb on there. I'm going to hold them in place because we haven't tied off yet. I'm not going to tie off to the very end of our stitching. Okay, so now we're going to pick up another three beads. It's really very simple. I am a beginner bead embroidery, and if I can do it, so can you. Okay, once again, I'm carrying the thread that's carrying the beads. I'm kind of pulling it in a circular shape. Then I'm using my needle to push those beads back, okay? And then I'm placing it directly at the end of those three beads. I'm going to pull my thread through like that. And then, like before, I'm going to go back to back one hole. And it's so nice because you've already got that hole made. Just keeps it simple. Come back up to the front. And this time, so I'm going to pick up one bead from the first three beads and then go right through the three beads, the new three beads that we just added. Put my thumb on it. I'm pulling, but I'm not pulling it terribly hard because you don't want it to buckle. Okay, so I'll show you a couple more of how to do this. One, maybe two more times. So I'm picking up my three 15-0s, pulling them down to the surface. Let me get back on camera here. Again, I've got my thread in hand, my left hand. I'm pushing those beads back with my needle so they're not spread out, and then staying within the color of the circle, going straight down through that canvas. Whoops. Just like that. Okay. Then again, we go back one hole. Makes it so easy to do. Thank you for sharing that link, whoever just shared it. And again, I'm picking up the last bead of the last three, and then all three of these new three beads, just like that. So you add three, go back through four, okay? So it's super simple. So you're just gonna make your way around, and I have one in which I have done just that by the magic of television, just like a cooking show. Wow, how about that? Candy Cooper has a cooking show now, or a group. So I have made my way all the way around. Let's just go ahead and finish this up so I can show you how to tie off. I've got my three beads and I am going to lay it down and see. And it looks like we actually need four beads. So I'm just going to, this time, I'm going to cheat a little and do four beads. I just want it to end perfectly where the very first beads begin. Okay, so I'm pulling that through just like that. Well, once again, I'm going to go back a hole, back one hole. Wait, did I do that right? No, I didn't. I go back here. There we go. I was going up instead of down. Excuse me for my sniffle. So this time I'm going to go through 5 beads. Actually, I'm going to go through more than that because I just want that circle to join just like that. And then I'm going to go down through the canvas inside this colored circle. Do not go outside the circle. See, all my beads are on the inside. And I am going to, I just want to bring my needle back to the back. Okay, and here's, so wow, my tail ended up pretty long. So I am going to just take the tail and tie an overhand knot, just like this, like tying your shoes. Okay, and then I'm going to do that again. And that's it. So, gonna trim both sides. Now, you're going to get, let's get rid of the excess. You'll notice on here there are little, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 little light blue dots. There's 1, 2 yellow dots. Pardon me, and I'm going to place one bead directly in the center of the heart. Now these beads, I'm just going to do a couple, and then so we can move on and show you how to glue your pendant in, because I don't want to run over. So I'm going to start with the bead right in the center of the heart, and all I do is put my thumbnail where I think that should be, and then try to bring my needle up there. Sorry, I was off camera. Bring my needle up, and that's not quite center. You may make a couple holes, it's okay. Well, so just try till you get your needle to come up in the, there we go, the center of that heart. So again, you're gonna leave a tail. And you got a little tiny bag of beads. And these beads, there's more than you need, but they go on the surface. So you had your teal 15 O's. So here's a group of 8 O's, 11 O's, and 15 O's. So I'm picking up the 8 O, and I'm going to go bring it down to the surface. I want it to stand on its side, and then I'm going to go straight down through the canvas again. Pull that in. See, it's laying on its side. I don't want it on its side. Okay, so it's right in the middle, just like that. I don't know, it just gives it some dimension. If you don't want to, you wouldn't really even have to do this. Then I'm going to go right back to that first hole. And I'm going to go through it again just for good measure's sake, okay? So you're going to do each of the beads on the surface this way. Go through it twice. Oops, got caught on the corner there. And then you're going to tie off. So each bead that you add to the surface is done exactly like that. So I am going to skip ahead. You just tie off twice and then trim it off, okay? For time's sake, I have one that is all done beading. And you can see here, let me get something I can use as a pointer. I have my 8-0 here. I have these off-white 11-0s. I have one here and one here, and then I have these really beautiful light teal turquoise 15 O's, and there's 4 of those, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and each one is put on exactly like the bead I showed you there. Now it is time to go ahead and very carefully, I've got my scissors, and I'm cutting along the outside edge. I don't want white showing, so I'm just going to cut really slowly. But I don't want my scissors going into the color, because then I could absolutely cut into my stitching, which would be bad. So just take your time when you're cutting your circle. I just hope you enjoy this project. Okay. If you see any needle holes, steer away. So I'm just very carefully cutting it all the way out. And then we're going to secure all that stitching because we're going to put glue on the back of this. All right. Okay. Oh, I have almost done it. Yay. So I've got that all cut off. Now I'm going to bring, let's see, I'm going to grab a little piece of paper so I can glue on that, not on my beadboard. So the kind of glue that I'll be using, get my little glue dish. I'm using Aileen's Tacky Glue. She was a friend of mine, and the glue is fabulous. You could even use, if you have some of the Phi Beings leather glue, you could use that too. So I just put a little bit, I actually put a little bit too much out in my on my dish. I'm using a 1/4 inch, so this is a flat. I'm going to turn this over. I'm going to pick up, get a nice even amount on my brush. And I'm holding it down with one finger, as you can see. You don't want to overdo it, but you want to go over all these stitches. I work from the center out. Okay. Like this. And then I'm going to let go for a second, turn it, hold it down again. Then I've got to get glue on the place where the where my finger was. So just make sure you get this whole thing covered really well. And then I'm going to pick up a little bit extra and put it right in the middle because I really want it to adhere to our... Oops, I'm going to put my brush in water so it doesn't get ruined. All right, so here is our insert, okay? And I am just going to place this right on here, and I'm going to press. Press, 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 press. Super cool. Normally I would say to let this dry for a few minutes, but I'm going to go ahead and now turn that over. Or does this have a stick? Oh, look, this has a sticky back. We don't have to glue it. You see, I'm peeling off this top layer, and this, oh, it doesn't have a sticky back. I thought it might. Getting my brush back out, and we're going to put, you know what you could do here? If you wanted to, you could write with a marking pen, with a fine tip, or a wood burner, and place something inspirational right here in the heart of this pendant. I think since this, as it turns out, I didn't really notice that it was like a, almost like a really thin plexiglass, I think it would be much smarter if I used my favorite glue, the Loctite Super Glue Gel Control. So what I'm going to do, you know, I think I'm going to write something in mine, and let's see if I can find a marker. I think I'm going to write, "Be true to yourself." So I will carry that message around with me, and I'm going to open up my super glue here, and let's see, I think I could place them right here. I'm just going to place it strategic dots along the way, because you don't need a lot of this glue, and you don't want it to squish out. Now, here's the tricky part. Let's align We got to get it going straight up and down, okay? Then we've got to get our heart pin, because once you drop it in, oops, see, it's turning a little. I got to move it. There. You want everything lined up, okay? And then I'm just going to press that again. Really pressing. Okay. Okay. So that's all there is to making one of these beautiful heart wisdom pendants. Get rid of my paper here. And now we're going to go. I've got my directions here just so I don't skip anything. I just want to do a good job. Okay, so we did the trimming. So now we are going to open up our beading wire and our crimp tube. Oh no, I don't see my crimper. So I took tools with me to Hawaii and I think I left all of them in my home. And I used to have an extra set here. I will look. But I think I have one at home and one in the box I took to Hawaii. So you're going to be crimping and I'm just going to be flattening. The first thing we're going to do is take your, I'm going to zoom back out a little bit. You want to take your beading wire, just run it through your fingers to try and get some of the coiling out of that. Okay. Just get it out of the way. So it warms up a little and I'm going to pick up one of my crimp beads. I'm going to pick up 8 of the 15 O's. 1, 2, okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They're little. 8. I'm going to go through one side. Oh, Sherry, thank you. That was very kind of you to say. Hey, Leslie. So I'm going to go through one side of the... So, and you'll see, because this is... I have to hold pretty close to get through, because what's happening here is there's wire. This wire is made of metal, and so the magnet is pulling it down when you try to go through one of the sides, okay? So now I'm going to pick up 8 more on the other side. Okay, super easy. I'll try not to count out loud this time. You don't really need that. There's 6. All right, now. I'm so embarrassed that I don't have a crimper. My goodness, please forgive me. This is where we're going to go right back. I'm isolating the crimp and I'm going right back through that crimp bead, okay? I'm going to pull the crimp bead down. And this is where you crimp the bead. Since I failed to bring my crimper, I'm seriously embarrassed. I'm going to just, I broke a bead, but I'm just going to flatten it out like that. You will then crimp the rest of yours, okay? At least it's holding well. And then we're going to trim off the short tail carefully. All right. Save our other crimp tube. Okay, so please forgive, that's supposed to be crimped. Okay, here's where I'm going to get out my actual necklace so I can follow my design. It's very simple. So what we're going to do now is use 30 of the 6mm American turquoise beads. Here, I forget where it's from. I think it's from Nevada. It kind of looks like Kingman. So I'm just going to pick all of these up. And while I do that, I am going to play for you my first recording, okay? So, here we go.
Heart wisdom is a profound concept that resonates deeply in both personal growth and interpersonal relationships. It's a combination of emotional intelligence, empathy, intuition, and a deep understanding of oneself and others. It's a unique blend of attributes that functions as a compass for navigating life's complexities, fostering a more compassionate, mindful, and fulfilling existence at a deeper level than the normal everyday existence.
Okay, so I'm really liking sharing with you because stringing is pretty boring to watch. So, but that is my concept of heart wisdom. It's a combination of things, you know. Normally society goes by just your mind, and I'll tell you, between all the TV and the screen time, your mind gets shaped. And the real way your brain works is the thoughts that you have, the more habitual they are, the neurons, the pathways become more like wagon wheels because they get used over and over again. So in order to keep your mind fresh and out of ruts, you need to be doing and learning new things. And that is why I am sharing with you as we do something that I've done a million times before. Oh, thank you. Glad you thought. It is heartfelt. It's all about wisdom. I call it heart wisdom because thinking has little to do with what I consider to be heart wisdom. Oops. Going kind of slow here. Uh-oh. I'm running out of time. I have to speed it up a little. But luckily, there's a half hour in between all the presentations. So if I have to go over a little bit, I will not get in trouble. No, I will not. Well, I just need to try to move along here. I timed it out, but you never know. When you're going live, things seem to change and warp somehow, for sure. Okay. Get caught here. So, a few more beads, turquoise, and then we're going to move to the 6mm wooden beads. But before we're due, we're going to place one of our sterling silver bally beads, spacer beads, right between the turquoise and the wood. So, we're getting there. Okay. Find the hole on this guy. One more. Whew. All right. So I've got my 30 beads on here, and I'm going to pick up my bally bead like that. And I'm going to start on my wooden beads, my 8mm. Excuse me, my 6. No. Yeah. These are 8mm. Okay, so I'm going to play the next recording for you.
At its core, heart wisdom is about understanding and aligning with emotional and intuitive aspects of ourselves, unlike traditional intelligence, which is often measured by cognitive abilities. Heart wisdom focuses on the ability to connect and understand emotions, both our own and those of others. It encompasses an inner knowing that goes far beyond logical reasoning. It taps into a deeper level of consciousness.
So we're going to put on 8 of these 8mm on this side and then use the other 8 on the other side. Okay. So I looked at the clock. I shouldn't have. I made myself nervous, but I need to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 more. Come on, buddy. I love the warmth of this color of wood. It's so pretty. All right, so I've got my eight millimeter beads on. And then I'm going to now move directly into my 10 millimeter beads, and I'm going to put five of those on, okay? So I'm going to play another recording while I do that.
Heart Wisdom functions as an internal guide, an intuitive, emotional guide. It helps us in recognizing and understanding our emotional responses and those of all the people around us. This understanding leads to better decision-making, not just based on logic, but also on how these decisions impact ourselves and others emotionally. By tapping into heart wisdom, individuals can navigate complex social dynamics and the personal challenges that life throws at us with greater empathy and insight.
So, I've got my 5, 10 millimeter, 12, whatever they are, and now I'm going to pick up, I'm going to pick up my another 6 millimeter turquoise. Then I'm picking up one of my 4 millimeter silver daisy spacers, and then I am going to go from left to right through my pendant. Okay, just like that. Super simple. So simple. Okay, from here on out, we're just going to be doing the exact same thing, but backwards. So what I need now is my other 4 millimeter daisy spacer, and my last. So I had these beads separated in 30s, and then I had one in one tray of wooden beads and another, because we're just highlighting this pendant by adding a little turquoise to pull your eye back in, just like that. So now I'm going to play another recording while I do my wooden beads, which is 5 and 8, starting with the 10 millimeter. Okay.
So the importance of heart wisdom in a world where logical intelligence is often prioritized, the importance of heart wisdom can't be overstated. It plays a crucial role in building strong, empathetic relationships, fostering emotional health, and contributing to the overall well-being. Heart wisdom is also crucial in leadership, as it enables leaders to connect with their teams on a deeper level, inspiring and motivating them effectively. And that goes for our personal relationships as well.
Okay, so I did my 5 millimeter. I'm going to now do my 6 millimeter and play another recording for you.
You may be wondering how to cultivate and use heart wisdom. Well, cultivating heart wisdom involves a mix of introspection, empathy development, and mindfulness practices. Jewelry making is a mindful practice. So heart wisdom requires one to be attuned to their inner emotional state and to be developing a compassionate understanding of others' feelings, not just your own. Practices like meditation, reflective journalism, active listening can enhance one's capacity for heart wisdom. So can jewelry making. Just having a really good focus and paying attention and quieting your mind allows you automatically to have more response emotionally and to have more calm.
Okay, so I've got all my wooden beads on. Oh, I keep going out of frame. Oh, I'm so sorry. I got to pay attention more. So I've got my wooden beads on, and now I'm going to pick up my other sterling silver belly spacer bead, and then I will go ahead and add all 30 of our 6 millimeter beads, and I'll play what I think is the last recording that I have. Do you like the videos? Oh, thank you. I'm really happy because I didn't know how it would come across. And you know me, because of my concussions, I can no longer do two things at once very well. I used to do 3-4 things at the same time, but not anymore. And I really just wanted to share with you the spirit of this pendant and why I designed that symbol. So I'm just going along here, putting the next 36 millimeter turquoise on. Oh, I'm so glad. Thank you for letting me know. If you don't like it, don't be shy. Go ahead and let me know. I want to know. I really like when you share your opinions with me because it helps direct me in what I will continue to design for you. Okay? Cool. All right. So here is another recording. Oops. Come on.
As I just do the second half of our strand here, which is simply reversing the order of the first strand that we made going up to the pendant, I'd like to just talk about 10 ways to apply heart wisdom in your daily life. Number one is mindful communication. Use empathy and understanding to communicate more effectively and compassionately. Number two, conflict resolution. Applying emotional intelligence to resolve disputes amicably and with understanding. Step three, self-reflection. Regularly engage in introspection to understand personal emotions and motivations, where they come from, why they're happening, and how to keep your balance emotionally. Empathy in relationships. This is an important one. Deepening relationships by being more empathetic and understanding of other people's feelings. Step outside your own story. Number five, decision making. Consider emotional consequences in decision making processes. Don't make reactionary decisions. Number six, stress management. Using emotional awareness to recognize and manage stress. Leadership, leading with compassion, empathy, and understanding. And I'm trying to share this with you guys so I can be a better teacher and we can connect more fully. And hopefully you can learn more than just jewelry making while we make simple projects. Number nine, community engagement. Applying heart wisdom in understanding and addressing community issues. Teaching and mentoring is number 10, using emotional intelligence to guide and mentor others effectively.
So those were the 10 ways I thought were good use of heart wisdom. So obviously you know that my intelligence, my strongest intelligence is not in my head. It's in my eyes, in my heart, in my intuition, and in my, I just navigate more from that end of things in my visuals. Okay, so I strung all 30 of those on, and I'm picking up my crimp tube, and I am going to pick up 8. Let's get some over here. Pick up 8 of my 15-0 teal seed beads. Okay. Little tiny, tiny beads. Teeny, tiny little beads. So, I wanted them to be small, though at this point my eyes are a little tired. So it's taking me a tad bit longer to go ahead and get them on. And I don't have my good cutters here. Oftentimes, if you're having trouble stringing, you want to just cut the end, and then try again. And usually it goes much smoother. Yep, there we go. So that's 5, 6, 7, and 8. Much smoother. Okay, so I've got to get to the other side here. We're going to go first thing, see, there's some gaps here. We want to make sure, I'm going to hold it up. I can't do it all on camera. I'm just letting gravity take all of the spaces from between the beads, okay? And then I'm going to go right through the second half of the clasp, pick up 8 more 15-0s in teal. And then we will almost be done, my friends. And wow, there's lots more great presentations to come after me. So there's going to be a half hour break. And then after me is the wonderful Kristen and Sarah. Oh, I think I got more. Wait a minute. I did this wrong. So I got to put on 8. Oh, you know what I did? I had it right and it just went through. Oh, for heaven's sakes, I apologize. I get to pick up 16 beads here since now I know it goes through the hole on the... I shouldn't have pulled those off. Duh. Yep. I had to make one mistake while I was... Okay, 2. Forgot my crimper. So, my apologies to you. Yes, you can watch any of the presentations because they're recorded. And they'll be there in perpetuity. So they're going to be there. You can go back. I can't believe this is our 5th year of doing the TGBE. You know, we started because everyone was on lockdown. And we couldn't go do our shows. We couldn't do our trade shows. We couldn't travel. Okay, I'm going through. And I'm going to remember my last 8 beads here. So we didn't think it was going to be an ongoing thing. We just thought it would be a short-term fix. But it became so popular that it has become. This is, I think, our 14th show. So I think Sarah said that's what it was last night in the preview. Oh, so 4. These are getting harder as I go. My little eyes. I'm getting going in for new glasses this week. My eyes change most every day now, which is really very tough. So I want to get some of these beads back through that clasp here. There we go. And then I'm going to isolate my crimp. I'm going to go back through the crimp. And I'm going to pull, I'm going to check one more time and make sure that I have no space. And then I am going to, this is where you would crimp, kids, but not me because I forgot my crimper. I'm just going to really press very hard. And then I'm going to trim off the tail. And voila! This is completed. And look, it just turned to 1 hour. So let me pop back up here and tell you thank you so much for being here. And don't forget, do a little shopping at JillMcCabe.com. I so appreciate having all of you and all of your support. You're just the absolute best, okay? And next is Sarah and Kristen, and you got a half hour to sneak out, have some lunch, and come back, and you'll have more presentations after that. I thank you from my heart, and I'll see you soon. I won't have a live tomorrow because TGBE is going on, but I will have, I will be starting again on Wednesday with my regular lives after my month-long vacation. So, mwah. All right. Thank you all. I so appreciate you. Take good care. Bye-bye.